Hi, my name is Gigi Terzian, and today we're going to be learning how to make our first 3D model in SketchUp. Let's begin. So SketchUp is a 3D modeling software that we're going to use to build our first 3D model. Let me show you some examples. You can make anything from a scene of a floating boat to a living room with furniture, interior design. This was a rendering done for a restaurant. And next, we're going to learn about the tools that we can offer in SketchUp. So to the left, you're going to notice the tools. And here it goes into a little more detail. You can take your time to look over those. So let's begin our first 3D model. So SketchUp is free. It's web-based. You can sign up online, just SketchUp.com. And then once you get in, you're going to create a new template using feet and inches. This is my go-to. So you can see there's a person on the screen, and that person is just there to help you with scale. So let's name our first model. I'm going to call it my 3D model home, and we're going to save it. Next, we're going to work on dragging a rectangle square on the floor so we can create our base for the house. So you can see your access points, the blue, green, and red, direct you in the X, Y, and Z axis. So let's take our rectangle. We'll begin at the origin, and then we're going to click and drag, let go of your mouse, look at the dimensions, and just go ahead and type in 12 feet, 12 feet. And there you go. You have your floor for the bottom of your house. Next, take your extrude tool. This one will help us create an actual 3D model. So click and drag up, and go ahead and type in 8 feet, and you can see at the bottom right hand corner you have a distance and measurement tool to help you know what you're working on. After that, you want to orbit. You can orbit tool just to look around your model that you just built. And to the right, you're going to find your view panel. This will help you just pick the right view for your model so you can start drawing right away. So take your pencil, find the midpoint, click once, drag it across, and click again at the midpoint. Then go ahead and look at your model from a perspective view. Next, you're going to grab your move tool. You're going to click once, drag it up along the blue axis. You're going to know it's blue axis because you'll see dashed blue lines right below the move tool. And once you're happy with the height, or you can type in 4 feet and just release the mouse. Now I want to look at my model from the front. And I'm going to build my door. So I'm gonna measure from the left, and I'm gonna type in 4 feet, enter. And I'm gonna do the same from the right, click, drag, release your mouse as you're dragging, and type in 4 feet. Now I have a 4 foot width. And these measurement tools are just to help you trace out where your door is going to be so it's accurately placed in the center of your front of your house. Grab your rectangle tool, start at one intersection, and drag it up to the opposite intersection, click, and release the mouse. Next, grab your extrude tool. You're gonna click, and then you're gonna push it in just about 6 inches. Next, grab your select tool. You can either select your dashed lines that you just drew, or you can erase them because we don't need those anymore. Those were just to help us trace out our door. Click on the face of the door. You're going to cut. So you can do edit cut, or you can do command X and then command V. And then we paste it out in space right around the house. You'll see why in a second, why I just did this. So now you can see inside of the house because we removed that face of the door. We can move the person right outside just so you can get an idea of what the scale looks like of the house. Next, I want to look at it in a perspective view. So I want to add some thickness to my door. So I'm going to grab the extrude tool. I'm going to type in 3 inches. So now I have a 3-inch thick door. I'm going to go to my 3D warehouse and I'm going to find a doorknob for the front of my door. So once I found my doorknob, I need to edit the components because right now those two doorknobs are placed together. So what I want to do is separate them so I can have one for the front and one for the back. So I'm going to edit my group multiple times. This is a design that somebody else has created and they have shared it in the warehouse. So I'm going to move it out and I'm just going to show you just by moving it, it's still considering it part of the group that it was originally in. So what I want to do is cut. And when I click outside of my object, that closes the grouping. And then I can go ahead and paste the other doorknob out. So let's place that front doorknob by selecting the move tool. And we're going to place it right on the front of that door. And you want to grab it on the back of the doorknob, the flattest panel on the back, just so it lays flat against the front of the door. Then we're going to orbit around and we're going to look at the back of the door. And then I'm going to paste my other doorknob so that I can turn it, flip along. And red was not the right one, so let's select another one. We're gonna flip it along the green axis, and then I'm gonna move it so it sits nice and flush on the door. And if you orbit around, you can take a look and see if you put it in the right spot. Otherwise, you can make some edits later on. So we're just going to modify it just a little bit. I'm gonna move it up a little higher. And it's a little tricky. You're going to have to keep orbiting and moving and placing it until it gets in the right spot. Great, that looks good. Now I'm going to look at it from the front view. I'm going to move that just a little more. That looks about right. And next, what I want to do is just make a little window for our front door. So we're going to take our measuring tool. Measure down as much as you want. It's your design. So what I'm doing is just about 2 feet down for the bottom of the window, 8 inches from left and 8 inches from the right. And there I have my outline for the window. So I'm going to get my rectangle. I'm going to start from one corner, go to the other. Then I'm going to extrude it inwards so that I make it hollow. And the best way to do that is see where that little red dot just landed on the back of the door. That's how you make it hollow. You push it all the way in until it reaches the back end of the door panel. And then you can go ahead and select your materials. And you can create a glass look so that you can see through the material. So let's extrude that again. Okay. And then I had copy, or I had cut actually, and pasted it back on and made that into glass. I'm going to orbit around. I'm going to paste that same rectangle on the back and turn that into glass as well using my paint bucket. And now I can go ahead and remove those trace lines, the measuring lines, with my eraser tool. Great. So now we want to look at it from the front. Let's delete all the other dash lines that are still there. If it doesn't seem to want to delete, you can use your select tool, double click. And see where it's hiding. And then go ahead and select it and hit delete key or backspace on your keyboard, or you can use the eraser tool. So now I want to make my door a group to make it one entire piece. If we don't do this and then we decide to move the door onto the house, it's just going to remain as separate pieces. So the doorknobs would be separate from the window, from the other doorknob, and so on. So by making it a group, we just created one entire piece. So then we want to rotate it. So you can get your rotate tool. You want to make sure you are on the flattest portion of the top of the door, and you'll know by it displaying a blue tool. You can drag and move it into the front of the house. So next we're going to make a window. So we're going to do the same that we did with the front door window. We're just going to measure out about 2 feet from the left, 2 feet from the right, 3.5 feet from the bottom, and 1 foot from the top. Then we're going to take our rectangle tool. We're going to select one corner of the window and then drag it down to the opposite corner of the window. And then we're going to extrude it inwards just a little bit by 6 inches, just to give it that depth. And then we want to hollow it out so it looks like an actual window. We'll go ahead and delete those measurement dash lines. And then we want to create a glass kind of look. And you can do that on your own, as I taught you for the door. Let's start by painting it, and you can select your pattern of choice. There's a variety of surfaces you can use. I think I'm gonna go for some wood paneling on the outside of the house and some wood flooring for the inside of the house. And feel free to go crazy with this. So let's select our wood paneling. Brick looks kind of cool too, but I'm gonna stick with the wood paneling. Great. And you have to go all around, so you want to orbit around the house until you get all of the surfaces covered. So now we need some roofing material. How about we put this on? How's that look? I like that one. All right, let's go around on the other side. That looks good. And for a red door, just to top it off. You can get into as much detail as you want to. So let's put some furniture in the house. I want a sofa. So it automatically will load into your drawing area. And then you're gonna have to use your move tool to just maneuver it inside of the house, but there's an easy way. Do a search for section plane. This will allow us to cut into the house so we can see inside, making it easier for us to place our furniture in there. So you can use your move tool to move that section plane as deep as you need to. And then we're going to take your move tool, select the sofa, and we're going to grab it from the bottom. And we want to try to place it on the floor as flush as possible against the wall. Great. And we'll move our person inside the house. And you can go ahead and erase that section plane. Then you can orbit around. You can look inside. That looks good. So another really cool thing are the styles. You can change your style at the end. There's an assortment of them. Feel free to browse that library. And then if you change your mind, you can go back to the default style and it's the first option. Now let's clean up our drawing area. So let's remove our guides and access. And then I want to draw a floor so we can add some grass. So you want to take your rectangle tool. You want to make sure it's blue, meaning it's going to be laying flat on the floor. And you can change your view if that helps. You're going to click and drag as large as you want, as small as you want. And then you're going to take your paint bucket and you're going to select your preferred material. So I'm going to go with grass. Looks good. You can also go back into your 3D warehouse and you can add some trees, benches, whatever it is that you want. Again, that's a library full of objects that other people have created, so feel free to browse that. And it will automatically load into your drawing area and you can adjust them as needed if you click on each object and edit their components. So we're saving our model. It saves automatically into our folders. You can also export as a PNG and a variety of other files as well. You can download it and you can also print it. And you also have the option to make the background white. There you have it. Thanks so much for watching. Take care, everyone.